Hey guys and dolls, I didn't realize that it started already. Caught me being crazy. What's new, right? Well, hey guys and dolls, how's everybody doing today? We've had really rainy weather here in Austin like this whole month of May. So even though it was minimal May, it's been like minimal videos as well because there's sometimes no lighting. So I can't really film. So I'm catching like the last bits of light. There's already been a tornado warning one county over. So, these may be the last videos I make for all I know if we get hit by a tornado. But on a happier note, I'm going to make two videos today. So this one is going to be about alternatives for gift giving when you are not wanting to spend money, you're trying to conserve money, or you don't have money to spend, or just in general trying to get out of that giant loop of materialism and having to possess items. So that's the first one, and then the second video is going to be on howing. That's a new word. It's going to be on how to make money through self publishing. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, so today let's pretend it actually is May the 19th, but on the second video we're going to pretend it's another day. Okay, wink wink. But anyway, for today's hashtag party every day, because in 2015 we're trying to have a party every day because sometimes you just need something to celebrate. Today is Devil's Food Cake Day. So go, and my son makes awesome devil's food cake. He didn't make me that for Mother's Day. He made a vanilla one, which was fine. But go and get yourself some devil's food cake today. So let's talk about gift giving alternatives. Okay, a lot of times, especially if you have a big family, gift giving can be quite a burden on you. And just in general, if you're a single person on a very limited income, or even if you're a big family on a limited income, or if you just are sick of all the gift giving hype that goes on. A lot of people go into debt at the holidays for, giving gifts, and I think that's crazy. And I don't just mean like the December holidays. I mean like Mother's Day, Father's Day, Valentine's Day, Easter. It gets out of control. So I'm just going to give you a few ideas today to kind of, spark your brain a little bit. And with children in general, they don't really care if something is on clearance or on sale. So of course, that's going to be my first thing to say is buy. Go to toy stores and find their clearance area, okay? And that's, for kiddos, because it just doesn't matter. Also, a lot of times if you buy at the holidays or whatever, they'll have multi-packs of toys. Go ahead and bust that bad boy open. If you get something that has little toy cars or something, and there's five or six in there, bust them out. And if you got three, kiddos that want them, give two to each of them. In a little something with some candy and something else, and that's a great gift. Just that you thought of them generally is good. Also, on top of that, let's talk about grown-ups. And again, if there's multi-packs of things, that's a great way to break stuff up and make little gift baskets. We all have baskets laying around our house or some kind of box or something. So that's definitely something that you can do. Another idea that I like to do a lot of times, and this could be as simple as giving it as a hostess gift or for a birthday or Mother's Day, Valentine's Day, anything like that. And that is, we all have vases laying around our house that we don't want or don't need. So go ahead and grab a vase and either go buy some flowers at the store, grab some wildflowers that you see. Maybe you grow flowers in your garden, okay? Go ahead and put some in a vase and, clean the vase up and make it nice and pretty and all that. And, a little handmade card. That's wonderful because we've forgotten a lot of times gift giving is from the heart, and it's why you care about the person that makes more difference than what the gift is, generally speaking. Another thing that you could give that I like to give a lot of times, and that I have done, especially when I had zero income in certain points of my life, and because I'm a book hound, I read a lot of books. So if there was a book that I thought was really, really great, that someone in my life was, in that same situation, if it was a self-help or if it was a fiction book, and I thought that they would enjoy a fiction novel, I would go ahead and I'd give them my copy of that book, and I'd write down the title so I could buy it back later at a store in the future. Whoops, I'm dropping my pen. whenever that time came around. But in the front of it, I would write, a little message. A lot of times people don't like to actually write in the book, so that's okay. Just grab a piece of stationery and put a message in there as to why you're giving them that book, and that you care about them, or that that this topic was interesting to them. So that's a way to spend $0 at all. Next would be, of course, to create the famous coupon book. But get creative on these. It doesn't, even in the coupons, it doesn't have to be stuff you spend money on. And the best part about it is, if you do a book of 12 and have it where they get one item that they could redeem, or one thing that they could redeem every month, that gives them a gift, for 12 months of the year. And it could be as simple as just watching whatever they want to watch on TV, or making homemade popcorn, or making their favorite, dessert, something like that. Spending time with them, on the porch swing or whatever. Giving a foot rub, giving a back rub, any of those kind of things is great ideas to put in one of those coupon books. And for kids, it's even more fun because they, skip making your bed, for a week or something like that. And just fun, creative things. And people that love you are going to really appreciate something like that. Next thing is, if you know someone, you have to give them a gift, or need to give them a gift, or want to give them a gift, and they collect something, or they have an interest in something that you own. Maybe they've admired something that you have. Give it to them. It may be hard to part with it, but it's going to bring them so much more joy than you could ever get out of it. So give them the item. Another thought is, for example, if they're a collector, I had a friend that I lived next door to for a while, and she was very into teapots and tea and things like that. So if it were current day, one of the great things that you could do with that kind of a situation is, if you have a set of china, or if you have a set of, daily wear dishes or whatever, give them a cup and a saucer, and maybe a spoon from your, kitchen or something like that. And then write a cute note about, every time they use that, they can think of you, or, have tea on me and put a tea bag in it or something like that. So it's all about being creative. And of course, if you don't have china, don't give me comments saying, "Well, I don't have any china. I can't give somebody a teacup." There's something that you can think of that you can give somebody. So those are some ideas. Now, some ideas for gift wrap. One of my favorite one is to get just tissue paper that comes in like shoe boxes. Again, this is a way that if you've got a shoe box with tissue paper in it, you don't have to go buy tissue paper. But one of the fun things on that is to, and you can do this with regular just like sheets of butcher paper or something like that. Just lay it out flat and throw some paint on it, or throw some food color dye on it. Of course, do this outside, and let it dry. And then once it's done, the great thing to do is take that and crumple it up, and then lay it out smooth and flat again, because it gives it kind of an artistic flair. So that's one way. Of course, another way is fabric. Any kind of fabric that you've got. It could be an old shirt even that you cut up. It could be anything from an old costume that you cut up, and maybe the tulle or the sequins or something like that. Use that as a gift wrap. And then, of course, neckties make good fabric. They make good ways to tie it, in a bow. And you can also cut the tie apart itself, and use the silk, or the blend, fabric from the tie as either a tie, or to wrap a small trinket in, or something like that. So there's some ideas for you. Get your brain going. Leave it in the comments below. What kind of gift giving ideas can you think of that don't cost any money? Maybe that you've given, would like to give, or have received in your life. So on that note, guys and dolls, have a delicious, delightful, delirious day. Sun, please hold so I can make the second video, and I'll see y'all guys and dolls later.